Hello folks, and thanks for watching. Neptune Systems aquarium controllers have long been the leader in aquarium control and monitoring here in the United States. They're always coming out with innovative and practical products that solve many of the problems that diehard hobbyists like myself face on a daily basis. They've impressed us once again with the recent release of Neptune Fusion, which is a cloud-based interface that's really going to open up the door to advanced aquarium control and monitoring to many more hobbyists. In the video today, I was lucky enough to sit down with Terence Fugazzi from Neptune Systems in order to get some more insight into what makes the Neptune Fusion interface so special. We're going to show you guys just how easy to use and valuable a Neptune Apex controller can be for your home aquarium.
I guess in the very beginning of aquarium controllers in general, the idea was, how do I have something that can help me do these tasks? It was more of like a Swiss Army knife kind of thing. It's really morphed now into, how do I become more successful by having a more consistent aquarium, but moreover prevent catastrophic things from happening. Coral Magazine actually did a survey and said, you know, how many people have had a catastrophic event, you know, in their aquariums. It was like 65% or something like that. And it's no wonder why people leave the hobby in, say, 18 months. If you have all of that work invested in there and it just goes away. The sad part is that these things can happen so easily and so fast. You can be going out to dinner with your wife and your heater can stick on and your tank is going to cook. You can have, you know, go away for the weekend and your landlord can turn off the air conditioning to work on it and your aquarium can overheat. There are so many different things that can go wrong, and with having, you know, the Apex, you're now able to see that stuff and be able to take action if something like that were to happen. And that's the number one reason to have, you know, an Apex on your system. We've done a lot in the last couple of years to really reach out and change the approachability of the product, the ease of use of the product, et cetera. I mean, even the labels, I mean, for what it's worth. The real thing we've been working so hard on to make that happen is called Apex Fusion, which is our cloud service for the Apex that allows you to access your Apex from anywhere in the world, from any device, without any of the technological headaches.
Once you update your base unit with Fusion, all of the connections and setup can be done
The web. I mean, the beauty is that your Apex then becomes like any other computer on your home network, right? You plug it in, DHCP gives it an IP address, all that's still, you don't even have to worry about what that means.
So the first thing you'll notice is when you get your Apex, you're going to be sent to apexfusion.com and asked to create an account. Once you log in, the first thing that you're going to see is a list of all the Apexes that you have access to. So you'll notice on the left you have icons. The red exclamation points are Apexes that are no longer connected. The one with the arrow shows that your Apex firmware is out of date and an update's available. The gear itself can show information about your particular Apex, the version of the firmware, the serial number, etc. You have all the information right from this screen. Once you want to go to your Apex, you just click on it and you'll come right to the dashboard for your Apex. The entire Apex Fusion dashboard is completely configurable. All you need to do is go up to the upper right hand corner where the lock is. Once you unlock the dashboard, you'll notice that there's an unused box that opens up where you can drag things into that you don't want or drag things from, or you can just rearrange anything that you like and lock it back down. Make the dashboard exactly the way you want it. Now let's say you want to configure a particular outlet on your Apex. In this case, we want to maybe change the configuration on the fan. So you click on the gear next to that particular tile or that particular dashboard item, and you'll get to the configuration wizard where you can change the control type. In this case, it's a chiller, but it could be a heater or pH control. The icon for the display module, what you want the Apex to do if it loses communication, you want it to be on or off the fan, what probe you want it to use the temperature from, and what the set points are for the temperature. In this case, we want the fan to come on at 79.5 and go off at 79 degrees. But let's say we want to change it. We do need to send that information to your Apex from the Apex Fusion software. you notice that that button lights up orange when something's changed, and you click on it, and then it sends it from the Apex Fusion server down to your Apex and reconfigures your Apex for you. Now you can also see a whole list of every outlet on your Apex so that you can easily access them and click on them to configure them. You have variable speed outlets, alerts, vortex, standard outlets, it's all there. Another thing you can do with Apex Fusion very easily is configure LED lights that work off of the variable speed channels. This could be many different lights, Kessel lights or do-it-yourself lights. We've made it super simple for you to change the intensity of those lights across time using the Apex Fusion unified LED control. So to configure it, you click on the gear. You'll notice the time starts with midnight on the left, ends at midnight on the right. The intensity is the graph, and the points are changes in the graph where you want inflection changes in the intensity. And you can also compare different channels from the variable speed channels or the LED channels all in the same graph, so you can see what your greens or your blues, your whites, all of them are doing at any particular time, so that you can really easily set up the profile that you want for your LED lighting. So as you can see, it's really easy to add new points, change the inflection, compare it to other any other outlet, including vortex. You can compare your lighting or your flow pattern. You could use this for Tunzi pumps in addition to LEDs, so you can change the speed of the Tunzi pumps over time. Super simple to program, no real programming necessary anymore. Now what kind of a monitoring solution would it be if you couldn't go in and see some historical information about what's going on in your tank? And there's a really great graphing engine in Apex Fusion that allows you not only to see one particular input data, but also align it with other pieces of data so that you can look at trends in the aquarium, things that might be happening that you might want to identify.
So after talking with Terence and checking out the new Fusion interface, I was quite impressed with how much focus Neptune is placing on making Apex systems easy to use, yet still allowing for all the advanced control that us Reef geeks have come to expect out of aquarium controllers. Now if you're looking to get some added security for your home aquarium, please feel free to give us a call and talk with one of our customer service representatives in order to see what an Apex controller can do for you. We do appreciate you watching, and until next time, take care and happy reef keeping. Thank you.